Hey, good morning, and welcome to Walking in True Wisdom with your man, Pastor Reverend Artel Bellman Sr. And I want to thank you guys for participating in what God is saying to us through His Word and what He's saying in reference to wisdom. You know what? Many of us have challenges, walking in wisdom. Maybe we didn't have great parents, maybe we didn't have a father that was available to us. Maybe we had parents and even people in our lives who really couldn't share with us what God had to say about us. But hey, we're going to move to Proverbs 2 today. And in Proverbs 2, the first part of the scriptures we're going to look at deals with searching for wisdom. You know, when we search for something, we're trying to find something by looking for it harshly. We're trying to look and seek and carefully, thoroughly find something that we need or something we think we need. But hey, the thing that we really need to search for is wisdom. Searching for wisdom will put you in such a great place that, the Word God tells us that when we put the kingdom of God first, when we put God first, when we heed to His word, then wisdom will encamp around us and we will walk in the blessings of God. Doesn't mean you don't have temptations. Doesn't mean we won't make mistakes. Doesn't mean that we can't learn from our mistakes. But when we search for wisdom, as Solomon writes in the second proverb, we learn how to live a life that is a blessing, not just to us, not just to our family, not just to our friends, but even to our enemy, because Jesus said that we are to be salt and we are to be light. Hallelujah. Light meaning we show as walking epistles of God what God expects of all human beings. So let's get after it. In second Proverbs, we're going to break these into different sessions today, but we're going to begin with the first verse. My son, if thou wilt receive my words and hide my commandments with thee, so that thou incline thy ears unto wisdom and apply thy heart to understanding, yea, if thou criest after knowledges and lifted up thy voice for understanding, if thou seeketh her as silver and searchest for her as hidden treasures, thou shalt thou understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. Hallelujah. Look, true wisdom gives us structure and it gives us peace. And it gives us structure because God sets things in order that allows us to be a blessing and not to be a curse. Look, God then says, He says He gives us a peace that comes in our heart. And we get that peace because the knowledge and the understanding and the reverence of God manifest itself when we heed to this proverb that Solomon wrote. Look, he says, you seek it as silver, you search for her as hidden treasures. Hey, wisdom doesn't fall on us. We hear the voice of God. God gives us direction through counsel, through ministers, through parents, through those in authority. And then we walk in that structure and we walk in godly peace. Look, when you know who you are in God and you follow the commandments of God, you end up having a peace which surpasses all understanding. Hey, let's move on. In verse 6, you see these words. To understand a proverb and the interpretation, the words of the wise and their dark sayings, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. My son, hear the instruction of thy father and forsake not the law of thy mother, for they shall be an ornament of grace unto thy head and chains above your neck. Look, when we understand, if you want to understand something, you have to dive into it. And then you need to walk in the interpretation of that thing and the interpretation of that information that you may be trying to understand is still going to be based on God's word. God's word is a lamp unto our feet. It is a light stand in our walking in God, being walking epistles made of God. And when we understand God's word, when we interpret God's word correctly through the Holy Spirit, and we base it, then God's grace will be sufficient for us. Look, there are situations in your life that are going to frustrate you. Situations in your life that you really don't get and you don't understand and you can't even interpret what it means. But you know what? God's word can bring clarity and God's word will bring grace. Grace allows us to do God's will. Grace allows us to forgive those that are unforgivable. Grace allows us to love those that don't love us. Grace allows us to pray for those who despitefully use us. Hey, God's word and God's grace allows us to understand word of God. It allows us to interpret things that God is doing, and it allows us to be led by the Holy Spirit. You know, Jesus said it this way, "It is beneficial for you that I go away, that when I leave, I will send you a comforter who will lead you and guide you in all truth." And truth is who God is. God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. Did he not say it? Will he not make it so? Hallelujah. Let's drop down. In verse 10, we're going to see these words. "When wisdom entered into thy heart, and knowledge is pleasant unto thy soul, discretion shall preserve thee, understanding shall keep thee, to deliver thee from the ways of the evil man, and from the man that speaketh forward things." Look, our hearts and our minds are his when we listen to the word of God and his instruction. And when we do that, he will deliver us from sin and from evil. Look, he says, "I will enter into thy heart and my knowledge will be pleasant to thy soul." Look, in the soul is the mind, our emotions, and our feelings. And we don't want our soul to rule us. We want our spirit to rule us, and we want to have the heart of God. You know, the word tells us that he takes a heart of stone and he turns it into a heart of flesh. And what is he saying there? He's saying that he's going to make us empathetic, sympathetic to others, to other individuals' trials and their tribulations and their temptations, because it is going to be pleasant for us. And pleasant comes from the concept of it is our will to please our God. Hallelujah. Let's drop down to verse 13. "Who leaves a path of uprightness to walk in the ways of darkness? Who rejoices to do evil and delight in the frowardness of wickedness? Whosoever ways are crooked and they froward in their path." Look, when you know who God is, when you understand what the righteousness of God is, it is difficult for you to walk in darkness. But then he also says it's not impossible for you to walk in dark. He says those who reject God's wisdom will walk an ungodly path. Look, heaven and earth was born and created that we may dwell in eternity with God. Hell was created for those who disobeyed and followed Lucifer and were kicked out of heaven. God never intended for man to spend a moment in hell. God intended for the angels and Lucifer and those who chose not to worship him to be in hell. Look, God said in his word, "Listen, I don't want you to walk an ungodly path." You know what? Jesus said, "I can't." He said, "When you were yet still a sinner, I still loved you. When you didn't want to listen to my word, I still loved you. When you wanted to run after the enemy and Satan, I still loved you." You know why? "Because I gave my son that ye shall have the right to the tree of life." He said, "I came that you may have a right to the tree of life. It is God's will that none should perish, but that all come into everlasting life. Look, the New Testament verse for this is going to be John 15, 3 and 5. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself except it abide in the vine, no more can ye except ye abide in me. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit, for without me you can do nothing. Hey, run away from this wisdom that you don't need God. Run away from this wisdom that science has all the answers. Get away from this wisdom of Scientology or whatever is out there. Get out of this concept that, hey, I don't need Jesus. I can still be a good person. I can still be God. Look, ye gotta abide in him because he is the one who has cleansed you. He is the one that took your place. He was the one who took your death. He was the one who died so that you can live. Look, may God keep you. May God bless you. May God prosper you. Until next time. And remember, search for wisdom can only be found in our Savior and our Lord Jesus Christ. God bless.